What's up, everybody? It's Mod 6, and today we're talking tactics in Battle Royale, specifically how to clear platform. Now, if you watch any content on Battle Royale and Call of Duty Mobile, you'll have obviously come across Parker the Slayer. He constantly jumps platform, plays solo versus squad. He consistently clears platforms full of other players and then goes on to get the win. What I'm talking about today are the tactics involved in consistently clearing platform in squads or solo versus squads in Battle Royale. Now, I spent 10 years in the Army as an airborne infantry officer. I led troops in combat. I did 3 deployments to Afghanistan, and I know what I'm talking about when it comes to tactics. I like to have a little fun and apply it to Call of Duty Mobile and video games in general, and so that's what we're going to do today. Now, clearing platform consistently comes down to 6 techniques. We're going to go through each of the 6. I'm going to show you examples of how to implement those with my own gameplay, and then we've got some bloopers at the end because jumping platform in solo versus squads does not always work out so well. So stick around to the end if you want to see the ridiculous bloopers that result from trying to make a video like this. And right now we'll get right into these 6 techniques. The first technique is choosing your jump distance correctly. Now, when the platform is over water or the low ground, I tend to choose a jump distance of around 1,000 meters. Jumping at 1,000 meters is the right combination of jumping early and jumping with the right downward angle so that you can get to platform as fast as possible. Choosing this is really all a matter of angle and speed and timing, and with a bunch of testing, what I found is 1,000 meters works for the low ground platform. Now, when platform is above the high ground, you have to jump a little bit later because your chute will open earlier. So really you're working with different ground levels, and so that high ground platform, I like to jump at about 900 meters. Those distances work for me, and you have to pick an angle correctly so that you land with a late parachute opening right near the platform and then land at your targeted spot. Technique number 2 is land on a second level corner. Now, platform is split into 3 levels. The bottom level is the level that the helicopter is on. The middle level, the second level, includes the middle, which is kind of an annex, and the core in the middle there where the vending machines are, as well as the grassy areas. That second level grassy area, those corners, that is where you want to be landing. The third level, what I consider the third level, are the top 2 outside platform areas, as well as the roof and solar panels at the top. So I've split platform generally into 3 levels. That second level, those corners, they provide areas of cover with the planter boxes, the air conditioning unit thing, as well as crates that are there. And that's also where a bunch of weapons drops are. There's always 1 or 2 submachine guns or assault rifles near one of those corners. And so that gives you the highest likelihood of getting a useful weapon early in the game. Technique number 3 is establish good security in the first 10 to 20 seconds. The first 10 to 20 seconds are the most unstable and the least predictable when you're landing platform, especially playing squads. And so you want to look around your immediate area, be quick to a weapon, get a couple of kills if you need to establish your security in those first 10 to 20 seconds. Now, the reason why you're landing where you're landing is so that it makes those first couple of seconds easier. When you're landing on one of the outside corners there, you only have the area in front of you, and you can be confident that no one is behind you because there's no platform space behind you. So it lowers the amount of area that you have to deal with in order to get security in those first 10 to 20 seconds. Technique number 4 is to then rotate around the outside of platform, generally staying on that second level. So you want to rotate around the outside. This is a similar concept to rotating out around the outside of zone at the end of the match in the final circle, as well as rotating around the outside of a multiplayer map so that you can get to the next hard point or another point of domination. The reason why you're rotating around the outside of the second level of platform is so that your back, the area that you can't see is to the outside of platform where there aren't any enemy threats. If there's a helicopter out there, you can hear it and see it on the mini map. And so when you rotate around that way, you're only having to deal with what's in front of you, which lowers the chances of being caught off guard. So rotate around the outside of platform, addressing things that are in the middle core area, but don't go down there if you don't have to. Sometimes I'll venture down there to get a vest, but I'm quickly out of there because that's the most dangerous area on the platform for the entire fight. I generally don't go down there into that core area where the two vending machines are until I'm pretty sure platform is secure. And so you rotate around the outside, jumping up to the high ground if necessary to get the shots, get the kills that you need to, and clear platform. Technique number 5 is use the cables to maneuver vertically. Platform is pretty unique as an area on the map because it allows you to jump down and then use those cables vertically. And there are a bunch of different cables that are tied to different points on the platform. So it gives you essentially a third dimension to add to your maneuver plan. And so you can jump off platform when you're threatened, especially in those first 10 to 20 seconds, run across or land near the base of another cable, ride that thing up, and then you're at a different point on the platform, either with a more secure area or the element of surprise on enemies that are there. The 6th technique is choose your gunfights where you have the advantage. You can pick your gunfights carefully on platform because there are so many maneuver options. So to be successful on platform, you have to choose those gunfights carefully. Use that vertical maneuver option and pick those gunfights so that you have the highest likelihood of winning each one. By picking your gunfights carefully and implementing all of the other techniques, you'll increase your chances of clearing platform when you jump, especially solo versus squads. When you play solo versus squads, picking those gunfights and engagements is even more important because you have to be aware of more than just the individual other player that you're shooting at. You need to be aware of your surroundings. So pick those gunfights, pick those targets carefully, and then you'll be clearing platform and getting those victories in solo versus squads in no time. So now we're going to get into the gameplay and the examples of these principles implemented all together in a few platform clears. And then at the end of the video, we've got some ridiculous bloopers when it didn't go so well. Thank you. Look at this. Jumped off the back here. Woo! Woo! This is how you want to see platform go. Ah! I almost had him. I knew him. Had him in the sights! Let's see here. Baby. Just picking up this platform clear. We got the whole team still alive right now.
All right, that's it for the techniques. We're going to get into the bloopers, but before that, like the video if you liked it. Subscribe to the channel because you know you want to be a part of this. Hit the bell notification so you see these videos early and can get that first comment in. Here we go.
Ah!
That's it, guys. Thanks for sticking around. I'm streaming Tuesdays, Thursdays, Saturdays, and Sundays in a bunch of different places. And yeah, check it out. YouTube, Twitch, Facebook, Trovo every once in a while. Mod 6 album.